Let's call it what it really is. It's app-related fucking. You know, it's just having sex based off of JPEGs and characters. That's it. You ain't nobody but a little thumbnail that could be swiped to the left or the right.
I'm gonna go on 3 dates this week, 2 dates next week. I'm gonna maybe go out with this other guy again. You're just dating so much.
Think of binge dating like a flight of beers, okay? You've got this huge selection. Oh, here, ooh, this is a little chocolatey. I'm kind of into chocolate. This one has a lot of hops. Not so much into hops. This one has no gag reflex. That's the one for me.
The best way to start binge dating is an app. Any app. Like, seriously, you'll just have a slew of them, just a stable of them. And you just keep them right there, and whoever bores you, you get rid of them, and then you, you know, pick up on somebody else.
And you just, like, scroll through the people, swipe left, right, whatever. When you match them, you talk to them, you go out with them. You like them, you go out again, and then you find more, and you keep doing it.
I know guys who set up dates with 2 different women in 1 day. A coffee date earlier on, and then drinks in the evening, and fuck them both. I wonder which one his soulmate is.
I don't know if girls are the new players. I think it's just shining a light on girls being players.
You don't go into it expecting to be a binge dater. It's like, he's cool because these two are out of town a lot. Then this guy over here, he's like a friend of a friend. My friend wanted to set me up with him, but he's a little bit crazy.
There's always an I guess guy. You're just like, ugh. I just cut my I guess guy out. I'm like, no, thank you.
And it's just like, we have so much going on. I don't think guys can handle that.
Yes, girls are the new players, but I'm pretty sure every dude is okay with being played as long as he's getting laid. Whew, that just made Johnny Cochran proud.
Location's tricky because let's say a guy has a lot of money, takes you somewhere really nice, right? You might think, oh, this means like there's something else to it. But no, he just has more money and that's just what he's used to. He's still a piece of shit.
Do not be fooled by that one guy who has a beard and he wears plaid and he's like, you know what? Let's not go to the bar. Let's do something crazy. Let's go to the bowling alley. It'll be so quirky and ironic. Guess what? That guy takes every bitch to the bowling alley.
Take them to a movie. If you take them to a movie, ain't gonna be much conversation. You gotta keep that in mind too. But dinner, drinks, it's gonna be a lot of conversation. It's all about what you want.
My ideal location for the first date, my apartment, obviously, okay? Now, if you're not willing to come to my apartment, of course, I'll recommend a lovely, quaint, romantic bar that happens to be located below my apartment. And then what will happen after that? Hopefully we'll go to my apartment. So it's not really a date, it's more of like a pit stop. Who has the money to date? Because you gotta pick up some of these meals. If you're picking up 3 meals for 2 people a week, you're looking at some serious expenditures.
My friend was telling me that she feels bad for guys because they have to spend so much money when they're playing the field. And I said, I wanna barf because I don't feel bad for guys. They make more money than us.
The world we live in now, I guess, you know, girls, they should be paying for at least half of it. But if you went out on a date with me, I would absolutely pay for 100% of it, but I would also expect a beach.
When I don't like a dude, I will fight to get that check. Yeah. So yeah. It doesn't become, I'll be like, wait, hold on, give me, I need this.
Yeah.
And I'm like, we were hanging out.
Just because a guy bought you a lobster and a bottle of expensive champagne, you don't have to fuck him. You can literally go, this was delightful, thank you for paying. I got another date I gotta go to.